Good day, friends. I am Excelblum, and today I will be answering the question, what exactly makes a Fire Emblem unit good at combat? Since the dawn of time, back when humanity was still a loose collection of primitive apes, Fire Emblem players have been making guides on GameFAQs, making tier lists on Serenus Forest, and making videos on YouTube. However, if you found a Fire Emblem player who has yet to come into contact with the rest of human society, and ask them what their favorite unit is and why, I would suspect that they would say something along the lines of, Amelia is good, she kills everything and doesn't die. However, now the prevailing consensus is that not only is this opinion wrong, but this person is also stupid for expressing it. Most analysis use stats as their main metric, either going by personal experience, bases and growths, or average stats. These numbers are looked at and compared to identify if a unit is good. However, I will now pose the question, are stats themselves actually the best way to evaluate your unit's effectiveness? If you are given a unit's stats, can you tell how good that unit is? Assuming you have no other information, I think this answer is no, because the relationship between a unit's stats and how good they are in combat is actually quite complex. We cannot simply take a sum total of all of a unit's stats and say that's how good they are. For one, some stats have higher value than others. For example, speed allows you to double enemies and avoid being doubled. This is a lot more valuable point by point than other stats such as luck. Additionally, each individual point of speed is valued differently from one another. When you hit the speed threshold to double, that particular speed point is worth more to towards your combat success than the one directly before or after it. The same can be said about strength. The point of strength that ensures you one-round an enemy is worth more than the points before or after it. Other stats are actually conditional, such as defense or resistance. Defense will provide you no benefit against magic damage, and resistance will provide you no benefit against physical damage. In other words, you cannot only look at one unit's stats to know how good they are, and this is because combat never exists in a vacuum. Your own stats are only half the equation when you consider the outcome of a battle. You must also consider the enemy's stats. The obvious problem is that it is difficult and tedious to do combat math against large numbers of enemies, especially when they have slightly randomized stats. Much current analysis depends on the player's intuition and knowledge of the game to identify how difficult the enemies are and how strong your units are in comparison. Now let's go back to that hypothetical Fire Emblem player who has never left his cave and never read a tier list. How does that person know whether or not their unit is good? I think the statement, Amelia is good, she kills everything and doesn't die, is actually quite poignant. And the reason I say this is because I think any Fire Emblem player has a good intuition of what units are good in the moment. The core of what makes a unit good is not necessarily the unit's stats, because those are just a means to an end. The actual important part is how well they do in combat, and what better metric is there than killing everything and not dying? More formally, I would put it as 1. How many rounds does it take to defeat an opponent? And 2, how many rounds of damage can you take from the opponent before dying? If a unit can one round an enemy, then clearly they have some sort of offensive merit. If they cannot defeat enemies reliably, then the performance is probably poor. Similarly, if your unit can take multiple rounds of damage from an enemy, their defense is probably adequate. However, if they die in one round, then they are a liability that needs to be protected. There are of course other strategies, tactics, and interesting maneuvers that matter, such as chipping and setting up kills to feed XP, but I won't be considering the added values of those factors at the moment. Measuring this metric is as simple or as complex as doing the combat calculations between your unit and the enemy unit. By my count, the Erica route of Fire Emblem 8, the Sacred Stones, has exactly 1,133 enemies. If we can measure your unit's combat success against each and every one of these enemies, that would provide an accurate measure of how good your unit is without relying on your personal intuition and experience. In order to do all this combat math without frying my brain, I decided to make a spreadsheet. This massive Excel spreadsheet can accurately perform combat math against every single enemy in Fire Emblem 8. I simulate everything that is relevant, including enemy stats, player stats, weapon stats, the weapon triangle, weapon effectiveness, and unique mechanics such as Brave Weapons and Luna. I then calculate two statistics from each player-enemy pair. 1. The number of rounds it takes to kill the enemy, and 2. The number of rounds it takes to die from the enemy. Then, for each chapter, I tally the total number of enemies that take X amount of rounds to defeat, and the same for the number of rounds it takes for the enemy to defeat you. Since each chapter has a different number of enemies, I then regularize the data by using proportions. I then multiply each category by a weight and add them together. This then produces two scores from 0 to 100 that summarizes how well a unit does offensively and defensively. An offensive score of 100 means that your unit is one rounding every enemy in the map. Lower scores means you take longer to accomplish this goal. A score of 0 indicates that your unit takes 6 or more rounds to defeat all enemies in the map. A defensive score of 100 means that you can take 6 or more rounds of damage from any enemy in the map. As this score decreases, it indicates that your unit can take fewer and fewer hits. A score of 0 means that you die in one round to everything on the map, which basically means that you are Amelia on her joining chapter. Generally, scores above 40 are usable, and scores above 60 are quite good. Now, armed with a more interpretable statistic, we can use it to calculate unit effectiveness for each chapter. For my first example, we will see how base level Seth performs against every chapter in the Erica route of Fire Emblem 8. We can see that Seth is functionally invincible in the early stages of the game, still quite usable in the middle of the game, though he starts to fall off in the late game without leveling up. However, note that if we arm him with the Silver Lance, he still ends up being pretty usable throughout the entire game. Now, one thing to note is that units do not stay at their base level throughout the whole game. In fact, their levels and stats are constantly changing every chapter, even sometimes multiple times per chapter. To account for this, I implemented a feature in my spreadsheet that simulates level ups per chapter. Now let's look at Seth, except he gains one level every two chapters. In this case, we can see that Seth is pretty good, even with a javelin throughout the entire game. And if we equip him with a Silver Lance, He's very, very good, even up until the final boss. Now that we have established the shocking, surprising truth that Seth is a good unit in Fire Emblem 8, let's look at a unit that is not so good. Here we have one of the best case Amelias, where we recruit her on Chapter 9, get her to Cavalier by Chapter 11, and then promote her to Paladin by Chapter 15. We can see that Amelia is quite the liability for at least her first 5 chapters or so. But if you do keep training her, she can provide a return on your investment. Whether or not that investment is worth it is a different story entirely. And that about sums it up for now. After months of work, I finally got the spreadsheet to a usable state and I wanted to show it off a little. I plan to add a lot more features, including accuracy, criticals, and some kind of reliability score meshing those together. In the future, please expect more videos on my progress in developing this project, and likely some character analysis videos using it. Please let me know in the comments below if there are any particular things you would like to see in this project, any particular units you would like me to analyze, or particular statistics you would like me to investigate. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. This is my first ever YouTube video, and any kind of advice or support you show really helps a lot. Thank you all very much, and have a good one.